The original was three discs, so added with Final Fantasy Remake 1, we got three. Yeah, like, it's just incredible that there's just that much game. Like, I probably won't attempt that on stream, at least not for a while, just because since I'm already playing through Final Fantasy 15, that's going to be a really, really long endeavor. I may end up playing that one on my own. Mouth still hurting, or may I call in the sauce favor? You can call in the sauce favor, but I'd recommend waiting just a little bit because, that way I can play the game a little bit, and then I'll still have the after effects of the sauce when I go into work, so it'll be that much more fun. In the near future, I'll be doing a mountain climb. I hope you'll enjoy what's to come. Hey, I always enjoy your photos, Cranberry. Like, is it gonna be like a huge mountain or just kind of like more of a hike, like kind of what we've seen before? Also, another thing. I played a little bit off stream last night, and I also added a ton of new outfits for Noctis via the Steam Workshop. So we've got more options to choose from. So, to give a little bit of a preview, we've got the Kingsglaive garb, which Noctis, of course, isn't supposed to have. The Organization 13 coat for all the Kingdom Hearts fans out there. Samurai armor. Raiden armor. The RPD uniform. Cloud's outfit, and even though it looks kind of awkward. And a blue kimono. No bikini? Yeah, well, that was because I was playing Wind Waker. Unless you're talking about getting a bikini on Noctis. Moogle suit. Unfortunately, I do have people trying to dox me, so I don't want to reveal where I'm going until after it's done for my own safety. All right, Cranberry, no problem. That's why usually whenever I post photos, it's usually a screenshot of a photo, just because of the EXIF data. Looks like the Final Fantasy Crisis Core outfit. Yeah, it's Cloud's outfit, I think, from the remake. But I don't know if it's actually using Noctis's actual arms, or if that's just Cloud's body plastered onto Noctis's model. No Moogle suit? I've got the Moogle suit, like. Are we talk? Oh no, you're talking about like the full-on Moogle suit, like not just the Chocobo Carnival outfit. You're talking like full-on Moogle. Hey, since you mentioned that, I'll have that ready for next time. So, based on these outfits, chat, what do you find interesting? So, the new outfits are as follows: the Kingsglaive, Organization 13, Samurai Armor, Raiden, the RPD uniform, Cloud's outfit, and the blue kimono that doesn't have physics. Is this the PC version? Yep, this is the PC version. Yeah, but now that you mention it, like I said, I'll remember that for next time. I'm kind of personally leaning towards the RPD uniform. Just because, like, that seems like something Capcom would do if Resident Evil 2 Remake came out around the time that Final Fantasy 15 did. Plus, I like how it gives that little bit of information under it too, that it kind of explains what it is. I like the Raiden, but I feel like it's a Metal Gear Rising. It's an MGS. Yeah, Raiden is a Metal Gear thing. Like, this is the Metal Gear Rising Revengeance outfit. any Rathalos armor or other Monster Hunter gear in those mods. These are just the ones that I got from last night. I'm sure there probably is, but these are just the only ones that I saw that really caught my eye. I'm sure there are. I've seen some before. But like I said, these were the only ones that I got just, like, from last night, after I played, so... I think I might go with the RPD uniform just because I'm going to be playing Resident Evil tomorrow, and I feel like that kind of theme-wise kind of fits with what I'm going. Yeah, it doesn't look too bad on Noctis either, like... So, I am going to try to get to Altissia. Honestly, I'll just be driving and listening, so looks aren't going to matter to me. Hey, no problem, Specs. Well, hey, I'm about to virtually drive anyway, so... So, I'm going to do a couple small things before I head to Altissia, but I pretty much did everything that I want to do in Lucis for the time being. So I think the ending part of the stream, kind of whenever I go dip out to get the hot sauce, is when I'm going to have the Altissia stuff play. Alright, no problem, Specs. Thanks for popping in, and I hope to see you tomorrow.
Ready for more?
You bet.
Let's hit it.
Yeah, I was up till like probably, I don't know, like 4 in the morning just doing side quests and stuff. Because I didn't want to leave any stone unturned, because I can come back to Lucis at any time. It's just that I didn't want to have so many side quests that I could have just done, like, just unfinished. Because right now I'm trying to get the parts for the Ultima Blade.
Everybody out.
But I don't think that I'm going to be able to get the Ultima Blade before I go to Altissia, just because the way that it works is that whenever you give the parts to Cid to upgrade the engine blade, you have to do like a bunch of side quests in the time frame that he's upgrading your sword. So right now I'm trying to get an item that I need to actually upgrade. Look, 4 a.m. would have been a nice sight for me. I was sleeping then. So quite literally, in your dreams. Wait, there's cars in Final Fantasy? What? Not just any car, you can augment the Regalia to be a monster truck, and also a flying car. Can't do any of those things right now, but it's something that I could potentially do in the future. There's a treasure over here somewhere. Yep, right here. But it's not a super huge deal if I can't get that blade before I go to Altissia.
Thanks.
Wait. Oh.
Never knew what hit him.
And apparently us as well.
You like that?
Solid. Put it in the books. It's history now.
A fantasy based in reality. I just want my knights back, but I did this to myself. Is that Sephiroth's blade? Hey, Pirate Fox! I haven't seen you in a while. Good to see ya. So, not quite. It's, the same length and shape, but it's actually the, sword from the episode Gladiolus, I think.
Seems we found what we were looking for.
I'm just doing a couple side quests to hopefully get an item I'm looking for, and then I'm heading to Altissia.
You rang?
That is my goal to the end of the stream, is to get to Altissia.
Hit it, Gladiolus. Gladio. You
asked for it. I also unlocked the playable characters last night, too, so...
Well, here we are.
Okay, I'm gonna go from a distance with Prompto. Now I actually feel like I'm a solid threat with all of these abilities. Because, like, when I played this game the first time, I usually scarcely played as Noctis once I unlocked the other party members. Alright, I'm gonna take care of some work for bits. I'll be looking for now. Good luck. Have fun. Alright, Big, thanks for popping in. Hope to see you soon. Yeah, it's like, usually it's either Gladio...
You wanna watch where you're going.
It's either Gladio or Prompto that I play as, preferably. It's actually probably quicker if I just jump off of here. I just love how the fastest mode of transportation next to a car in this game is quite literally just throwing your sword and teleporting to your sword. Let me see, did I get the item that I was looking for? Because I need to get something called a... It's like a smooth Helix horn or something. Crooked Helix horn. Nope. Gotta try it again.
Man, it's hot.
Then lose the jacket.
Bicorns dropped that.
Here.
All right, well, let's take a look. Because that's the one item that I need in order to upgrade the engine blade one more time.
Trust you've worked up an appetite.
But getting some gil and experience out of this isn't too bad either, because... By the time I leave for Altissia, I'll probably be at least, like, in my mid-level 50, like, in the mid-50s range.
Well, if you're game, these feisty fiends are keen to play.
Okay, so...
Come back soon. Kenny's waiting for you.
Helix horns are usually dropped by bicorns. You can target and break their horns off, and it gives you a better chance of dropping the item. Okay, do you know, like, kind of where the hunt is? Because right here, it's just Spiracorns, but it looks like I have to go somewhere else to find... The hunt version of the Spiracorn yields the sturdy Helix horn needed to make the ultimate blade. So I think there might be something that I can actually look at, like the archives here. Bestiary. Because this might give me some information as to where I can actually find them. What scares me is that there's so little that I've discovered in this bestiary. You need to repeat that hunt. Okay, so it's that specific one.
There you are.
Okay.
Kenny and I have been waiting for you. You must be tired from the trek. Take it easy now.
Target break any horns you can. Okay. See, that's the thing, is that I thought it was the opposite. Like, I think that's maybe why I didn't get it, is because I thought that you're supposed to spare the horns, but that actually makes more sense. And now I have to... Well, I guess I could just return to the car. I mean, a loading screen's gonna be a lot shorter than me running over there.
Keep it moving.
Mm-hmm. Right behind you.
This time, I will go straight for the horns, and then after that, switch to Prompto. I don't know, it's just the fact that Prompto has a rocket launcher just makes a lot of battles so trivial. Like, I'd say in order, it's probably Prompto, Gladio, Ignis, and then Noctis. Like, I love Noctis, but preferably... Well, I think actually Ignis is probably... I guess that's interchangeable. Rockets make everything go boom. I mean, that's why I have an explosive personality. Hey. There we go, the first drop that I get. Prompto time. Yeah, because just look at how devastating that is. Plus, later on, when I actually complete episode Prompto, I'll have the infinite ammo for the SMG. Because that's a equipable item you can get. Outstanding knocked. I'm the one who completely sweeped this entire area. Hey, you can't get onto me for that bad joke, Blaze, considering, what was it, last night you made a horrid joke in Tie the Tasmanian Tiger? What was it, like, there was a spike pit and you said, I see your point. Probably outstanding for not being able to dodge rockets. They must have went to the Vince Vaughn school of dodging. If you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball. If you can dodge traffic, you can dodge a ball. And if you can dodge traffic, well, you can't dodge rockets. Alright, so now that I've got that last part, it's really just a waiting game.
Is it evening already? Time flies when you're having fun.
Because the quest indicator says... Let's see, where is it? I think it's at the very bottom. Yeah, better engine blade. It's like, Cid will upgrade the engine blade, but it might take a while. Pass the time by undertaking quests and hunts. So it's basically just me waiting this whole time. However... I keep forgetting to bring the car back to the old Lestalem. Or sleeping. Yeah, I might do one more hunt, but I know exactly which hunt it's going to be. I've got to find the parking spot for it. Yeah, it's the area right next to the Rock of Ravato. Because there was a hunt that I did last night that's a really high-level enemy, but now that I can switch party members, I feel confident that I can actually take it on stream. Yeah, turn in the blade part first so the time doesn't count.
Do we have to walk?
Oh, well, it's already passing the time, so last night I gave him the metal scrap or whatever he needed. So right now, I'm just waiting for him to actually finish it. Oh, this is the wrong parking spot. You knocked that Hun out quickly. Boo! I'm only saying boo because I love it. Okay, it was the Mart. What are you talking about? I'm living... You know, that's the thing about puns, is that people will usually say, like, oh, we hate the pun, it's so bad. But, like, unless the pun is, like, super terrible, I usually, like, pretend to hate it, but I really love it.
Are you joining us?
Welcome, boys. Looks like you could use a good meal. That was a great help. Thanks.
Well, considering the Hunt was in a completely different location, I'm glad that he paid me all the same.
You boys hungry?
Quality is great. The QA engineers are unfortunately of interesting quality.
Want to put your skills to the test? It's in your hands.
Yeah, so you remember that giant bird that we encountered at the very beginning of the game? Well, we're now at the level we can actually fight that thing. So in theory, if I just use the quest location, it should take me right there. The rock. It's fun when you approach it like a giant chicken. Dwayne the Rock. It's like, I can't think of anything more clever to say, like, with the word rock. Rock and roll, Dwayne the Rock. What are my jokes, punishable? You should be careful with that, Blaze, because sooner or later somebody's gonna call in the Punisher. No, I love puns. No, someone's gonna call in good taste. Hey, like I said, I love puns. Like, if you give me, like, a clever pun, I'll most likely love it. You might have... Better than bad taste. See, like, I grew up around, like, sarcasm, Monty Python, and just slapstick humor. So, like, anything like that, just, I love. I don't know, it just gives me a sense of comfort and familiarity. Well, until Blaze gets better, he's going to have no taste. No taste is still better than bad taste. Good. You're kind of in a paradox in between the two. Wait, whoops, that. Oh.
And on we go.
Indeed.
Right.
My life is a paradox. So we're basically having a conversation about being in the limbo of good and bad taste. With the bad puns and the bad taste. And then the good puns being good. I don't know. We're in a complicated conversation. And my brain is not equipped to the task.
Don't be late.
Though it usually never is.
Not another one out.
No! We were just talking about puns! No! I don't know if you'll be able to do old events in Altissia, but one of the best ones I've had was playing hide-and-seek with baby chocobos. Aww. I actually don't remember that one, so I'm definitely going to have to try that. Because that sounds just absolutely adorable.
Nothing to it.
Yeah, because like in Final Fantasy 13, there's that one guy with the afro. And the baby chocobo chick lives in his afro. And ever since I saw that character in Final Fantasy 13, I've just loved chocobo. Well, baby chocobos. It was frustratingly quick. Yeah, like, I mean, if we're going to play with baby animals like that, we need to, it needs to be like a significant length. Like, enough to where we can sit back and enjoy it, but not short enough to where it's like it's here and then it's gone. It honestly does make me wonder, like, if chocobos were a real animal, it makes me wonder how you'd take care of them. Like, I'd imagine it'd be kind of similar to, like, maybe an ostrich or an emu. Because chocobos seem to be pretty docile, at least to humans. Because they're tameable to be able to be ridden on. But, like, I'm just thinking of other big birds, like the cassowary, and while you can, like, hold cassowaries in captivity, those things are pretty much living velociraptors. Yeah, there was that whole war against the emus. Yeah, like, cassowaries I didn't know about until, like, maybe 4 years ago. And they are they're really cool looking. They look like a living dinosaur. Which, I mean, technically they are, but probably one of the coolest birds I've ever seen.
They won't know what hit them.
My hero.
Those big billed birds that have machine gun calls. Those are the shoebills, so they're storks. I was actually thinking about this, strangely enough, the other day. So, shoebill storks are actually pretty docile, from my understanding. Like, they don't... I've not really seen a report that they've really attacked people. They're super freaking cool looking, though. Okay, switching to Prompto. I'm, like, hitting every single enemy up on the way up.
Far less trouble than anticipated.
Oh, hey, more XP is good. Well, hey, the bird made the mistake of encountering me. Like, it's not my fault that it decided to eat my rocket. It's not Wesker, you can't do that, bird. Well, hey, if I had the capability, I'd be firing two rockets from a helicopter, but the irony of that statement, considering that I'm in a volcano right now and I just beat Resident Evil 5... And because I beat Resident Evil 5, the next game that I'm going to play, of course, tomorrow on stream, after the first game that I'm playing by myself, will be Resident Evil 6. And we're in the RPD outfit, so yeah, we're pretty on brand. It'd be even better if it was a Chris Redfield outfit. But I just can't imagine Noctis with that big of muscles. It'd fit for Gladio, but not so much Noctis. But yeah, tomorrow I'm going to start the suffering of playing through Resident Evil 6. Of course, I have played the game before, but I've never actually streamed it. And I'm going to be bringing my brother back for another round of Resident Evil suffering. Jeez, Resident Evil 6 is such a long game, too. Like, it's... Like, there's so much to just suffer through. Like, there's fun. There's some fun parts of RE6. It's just ridiculous. Like, it's too over the top for its own good. Jill sandwich. Yeah, we're gonna be much more than a Jill sandwich. We're gonna be an entire buffet of Dak, Jerry, and Eno. Because Resident Evil 6 is quite the experience. Because, like, they tried to bring back a little bit of the scare, but also, they wanted to make it accessible to other audiences. So they added a lot of more action. So it really wasn't even a Resident Evil game anymore. It was just more of like a generic action Call of Duty shooter, basically. Oh, let me fix that. Where did Chris go? That boulder-punching bastard. Bringing my brother back for another round of suffering is true brotherly love. I mean, it really is. I mean, that's how we bond, is over our continuous failures in video games. And also purposely sabotaging traps whenever my brother goes in one.
The rest for the wicked.
Or if he goes across a bridge, I take the bridge out from under him.
Not there away. Is giant bird, and it's coming right at us.
No, get away from there.
Let go. I
can't. Get down.
We're not done for the meal, are we?
And it's circling for another pack.
Choice.
All right, gentlemen.
It's either him or us.
Let's go take out this giant bird. Do I have to literally stand right here? Oh, it's right there. Prompto, you may not want to stand directly there. Yeah, let's just roll ourselves out of that situation. Okay, there we go. Why is it coming directly towards me? Instant fucking kill, that's what I get. However, I made sure to stock up on Phoenix Down, so we're good. Maybe that's why this bird is level 67. I'm trapped in between its tail. Okay, so it's invulnerable to most bullets, but not to the rockets. Flare out. I mean, basically, this is Metal Gear Fantasy at this point.
Getting by.
Well, Monster Hunter, Metal Gear, Final Fantasy. Like, three different game series in one. Which, technically, Metal Gear did do a collab/crossover thing with... Oh, thank you for the subscription, Pirate Fox! I actually thought I got an achievement for a second, but I forgot that I had the Xbox achievement thing as my subscription. But thank you for the sub, Pirate Fox! Okay, where is he gonna land? Right there! I am trapped. This is not fun.
I know.
gotta roll my way out of there. Also, Gladio, you should use the Phoenix Down. However, okay, that didn't work out too well. But I've got rockets, so we're good. Here, let me switch to Ignis. Or, never mind, because Ignis is dead! Here, let's try Gladio out then. Worth it. So, that shield is definitely not impenetrable. I was trying to do a Dark Souls type thing, but didn't work. It's okay though. I've got plenty of healing items. Man, this thing is, like, kicking all of our asses at this point. Where are those summons when you need them? Am I right? I'm trying to get Gladio's, like, special move out, but it's, like, it's slow going. There we go! Now, Ignis, your turn. He ran right into his own death. It's like he just barely moved his talon, and then Ignis is just dead. Here, let's just stop for a quick bite to eat. Alright, back to Prompto. Or, no, because Prompto's in danger. Shit. Alright, Prompto. You're gonna finish this battle whether we want to or not. And all of my hits did absolutely nothing. When in doubt, just use a rocket. Ooh, look at that XP!
Magnificent.
Yeah, it was far from graceful, but we did it.
We're alive! Let's celebrate by eating something dead!
I dreamt about that Prompto miss. Like, the miss that I just did. Huh. Well, I guess even the universe, like, wants to let people be aware, and other spirits to be aware, that my aim is absolute shit. Also, I think I'm going the... Oh, wait, I can just return to the entrance. What am I doing? Because now that I got all that XP, I can go report back to the tipster, and then I can go back to Golden Key to get this double XP, and then, hopefully by that point, Cid will be done with the first upgrade of the engine blade. And then after that, I'll just, like, camp another day or two, and then I get the Ultima Blade, and then, Altissia. Actually, no, I could just go to Golden Key, because I think they have a hunter thing there, so. Because I can turn in the bounty there. Really, though, like, Golden Key, it gives you the double XP, but it's actually not the best place to stay. Because later on, whenever I get to Altissia, there's the Hotel La Ville, which is the hotel that you showed me and Blaze and Crazy Wolf in VR chat, Pirate Fox. It actually, like, from my understanding, gives you, like, 2.5 or, like, 3.0 bonus XP. But realistically, when thinking about it, I feel like the resort would be a lot more expensive and better to stay at than a hotel in Altissia. But then again, Altissia is more of like a... it's like a paradise city kind of thing. Like, but then again, I'm not really too familiar with like comparing like prices of a European trip versus a tropical vacation. Because it's something that I've been talking about on stream a lot, is that I really want to see the ocean someday. Because the only time I ever saw the ocean was through this side of the road stuff in Florida somewhere. I didn't actually get to go to a proper beach.
Welcome back.
Okay, cool.
You really are dependable.
Thing is with Altissia is you can't use that buff back in the first part of 15, at least in the beginning. Yeah. Yeah, I think mostly, like,
we use the freshest fish in every dish.
Used to be the Altissia was a one-way street.
Thank you for your
patience. Oh, like how you couldn't go back at all? Oh, I see. Because, like, later on they added Umbra where you were able to go back, so, yeah, that makes sense.
Will you be staying the night with us?
Yeah, because, like, I remember seeing this game, probably, like, the first time I ever saw this game was in, like, 2017, so it was still whenever it was really glitchy and they didn't really add all the quality of life stuff.
Gross.
Woohoo! Bath time!
But I didn't play it until the Royal Edition came out, so... I was kind of late to the party, but it's still a party nonetheless. Woohoo, level 55. That's pretty much exactly where I wanted to be. Alright, let's look at our pictures. Yeah, for sure.
Hey, this one's pretty good.
I know. I dig it too.
Look at you.
Yeah, I know.
Why you gotta be so photogenic?
It'd be nicer if that fur wasn't in the way.
Not bad.
Yeah, and I think that's just kind of a... okay, so we were talking about muscles, so we literally took a picture of Gladio's arm. Yeah, that's the thing with a lot of like new game releases nowadays, is that being... it's almost like you're an early adopter.
Hey, isn't that...
isn't what what?
Just my imagination.
That's you, Noctis. But it's like a lot of games nowadays, you kind of go into it being an early adopter because they add all these bug fixes and day one patches later on. Alright, thanks, Cid. There we go. The engine blade too, and then I'll just give it right back to him and say like, hey, can you upgrade this again? And then after that, I can feel comfortable actually selling my treasures because I know that I'm not going to need them for anything really specific. All right. Quest location? Well, actually, I can just do parking spot, Cape Kayan. Because I think what I can do is I can just, at least this is what I'm hoping for, is go give him the part, go do one hunt, sleep, and then come back, and hopefully it'll be done. Because the Ultima Blade you can get so early in the game, and it's the second best sword for Noctis. Like, there's one more sword that's better, but, like, in terms of, like, raw damage output, the Ultima Blade is, the second strongest sword for Noctis. It's like, you can get it so early in the game, and that's kind of what I was trying to do before I went to Altissia, was to get the Ultima Blade. But also finish up, like, loose ends and side quests that I needed to do. Yeah, because I've got roughly, like, 40-ish minutes left before I have to get ready for work. But I think, like, getting to Altissia is a good kind of, like, cliffhanger point where the next stream, when I pick up, I can, just get right back into the action. Which, once I get ahead for Altissia is when I will do the hot sauce. Or alternatively, Sarah, do you want me to do the hot sauce today? Or do you want me to do it tomorrow, which is my birthday? So, you'll see me suffer on my birthday playing Resident Evil 6 with hot sauce.
There y'all are. Get ready to be blown away.
Birthday hot sauce. Yeah, so I have a redeem where I drink a little bit of Hellfire hot sauce, Carolina Reaper sauce. It's a very expensive redeem, and I only do it because I have the stuff on hand. But I actually need to get some more because my bottle's getting kind of... I don't know, it's losing its potency.
Well, looks like we got...
My father used to do that to punish us as kids. Like, hot sauce? I guess I'm a glutton for punishment because I actually don't mind it. It's fun because I handle hot things very well and I love spicy foods.
Nice. Hand over your weapon and I'll get to work. If y'all are having car trouble, Cindy's your girl.
Yeah, there was also, I'm hoping to get another, like, bottle. Oh. See, I'm hoping to get some of that, some hotter sauce. Because, like, the one-chip challenge is one thing, because, like, I've heard about that and I've seen videos of it. The only problem with that is that it's, like, $20 for one chip. And I feel like it would be kind of wasted just to do it one time. So, like, having a bottle is better because I can just do it at any time.
Yeah, picked up junk to throw in my eyes.
But I am thinking of new redeems to do, because, like, there's a suggestion by another chat member on something that I could do that's a 10k redeem that isn't, like, causing me, like, pain. See, do I have any hunts that are active? Yeah. Let's do that one. Because I do have a redeem where, I think it's 500 where I put on my hand trackers. That's another redeem. I'm looking into VTuber Plus to add, like, some special things you can do to my avatar. For something that makes you have a lot of fun. Yeah, like, just to kind of supplement the agony that I'm in with... the hot sauce. Okay, now that I think about it, I probably should go rent a chocobo for this. So I'm gonna go to the chocobo post real quick. Or, actually, no, I could just go to... Yeah, well, I can just go here. So I get the chocobo, it'll be a lot easier for me to get up that mountain, and quicker. I don't know, terrible singing? I mean, I can try. 9 times out of 10, I usually just start singing randomly in stream in general, but if that's a full song you want, chat, I can provide. Because my microphone, for those who are curious out there, who are kind of into that audio spectrum kind of thing, I use a Shure PG-27 USB edition. So this is actually a vocal microphone that I use for commentary. It's the same microphone that Markiplier used for years before he switched to his current setup. I also have a shock mount for it, and it's also mounted to my desk, so it's completely suspended, so it's not like on my desk somewhere where it's gonna like rotate around. Okay. Quest location. The Chocobo Post is one of the best places in 15. See, I love it because the Chocobos are just adorable in this game. Like, I'm sure that in Final Fantasy 16, if Chocobos play, like, a huge role, they're probably going to be even more adorable, but ever since, like, the very first time I saw Chocobos, like, in general, was in Final Fantasy 7, which was kind of, like, my first official exposure to the series. And then, I saw Final Fantasy 6 and so on later on, but that was my first exposure to the Chocobos, was through the Chocobo racing in the Golden Saucer. And you can see high-def baby chocobos. They look like fat golden chickens, yes.
I'm going on ahead.
I like how these lanterns on the chocobo, or these lights, make it look like the chocobos are glowing. Because it's the same shade as their feathers. Plus, I just love the free roam aspect of riding a chocobo. Oh. Sarah, can you remove that? Looks like we got a bot in the chat. Nope, I am not doing your quest right now, Hiso.
Let's move.
Yeah. Here, let me get that real quick. Okay, there we go. Should got rid of the bots. All the little designs on 15 are just fun world building, like the lamps on chocobos at night. And the fact that they wanted to do so much more with it. Like, I remember whenever we went to Altissia in VR chat and you just showed me, like, all of the stuff. My answer to the bot is, I am Groot.
Iris is truly a caring soul. Like you. No wonder you get along like wildfire.
We do have much in common. Like our tales of picking up after the prince.
Glad I could be of service.
But yeah, like, we went to Altissia and you just showed me, like, all those, like, areas in the background and the distance that they were planning. It's just incredible what they had in mind for this game, but they were just, because of development hell and a lot of other issues, they didn't get to really fully realize that dream. Yeah, it probably would have taken me forever to get up this hill had I not rented a chocobo.
Huh.
All right, buddy. Thanks for the ride.
Thanks, buddy.
I mean, just look. They're just so cute. And also... Oh, okay then. Well, the reason they have four endings is that there were four different directors and they wanted to take the story in different ways, so they did all of them. Yeah, plus, I just really wish that they had been able to release the, episode, Noctis, Luna, and, Aranea. Especially episode Aranea, because that would have been really cool, because they had the diamond weapon planned, which was a Final Fantasy VII boss that was brought into the canon of 15, via the movie, and there... And the diamond weapon was going to be a boss in episode Aranea, but since that was canceled, we never got to see it.
Hey, where'd you learn that one, Noct?
My pleasure.
Well, considering that we can't see a thing, goodness. Those chocobos look delicious. I mean, hey, I would not be surprised if chocobo meat is a delicacy in the Final Fantasy universe, considering if we're talking about how they look like little fat chickens, then it's probably more than likely. Achieving Moon sent me a package with four games. Three of the four feature grappling hooks. There's definitely a theme here.
Look where you're going!
Didn't mean to do that.
We'll see, if I get a grappling hook in this game, Cranberry, I definitely would. And see, that's another thing that I was gonna do before I went to Altissia, was I was gonna deck out the regalia. So whenever I get the Ultima Blade, I'll probably head to... Well, I'll get the Golden Key first, and then I will head to Hammerhead, upgrade Regalia. Bionic Command. Like, Bionic Command or Bionic Commando? Bionic Commando.
This one's just for you.
None the worse for wear.
Yeah, that's actually a Capcom title from what I remember, because I remember, I think his name is Spencer as the main character. Because I remember, like, the actual Bionic Commando game, but then I remember Spencer being a playable character. I think that's his name in Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. No, I'm not kidding you.
Ready for this?
Listen to me, buddy.
You can see I have a bias towards Prompto. Because since he's so Metal Gear, and I'm a huge Metal Gear fan, like... Plus, I mean, he's got a rocket launcher that just erases bosses. Plus, you can do crack shot anytime the enemy is, like, vulnerable, and it just... It's just a cakewalk. Yeah, I didn't... Okay, I was gonna say, did I already kill it? No. This will. Definitely an improvement on the last time I fought that thing on stream, which I think was the last time you were in stream, Pirate Fox, because I had such trouble fighting that, and then I didn't have to use a single healing item that whole time. So I feel a sense of accomplishment from that. Okay, back to the entrance, and return to the car. Well, actually, no, I can just return to the rest point, because that's going to be Golden Key. Yeah, and I think a big part of that is just because I'm playing as Prompto. Because, like, if I was playing as Noctis, I'd still probably have a lot of trouble, but... I just like to play as Prompto a lot more. Probably just because of the Metal Gear-esque vibe that I get from his gameplay.
Will you be staying the night with us?
Yes, I will. Because I can actually afford it this time. If that's not character progression on my part, I don't know what is. I can stay at Golden Key anytime I want. Because of all the money that I have
now.
That's
what I call a good shot.
Jeez, Prompto. Like, did you literally, like, take that photo in direct sunlight? I mean, I could probably fix that photo, like, in post, but at the same time. That looks like an album cover. Keeping that. Yeah, like, the UV rays of the sun filter.
Stylish as always.
Okay. Let's see, what's next? Okay, so Cid is still working on the Ultima Blade. Did you ever find the demo? Yes, I did! So I do have Carbuncle. Okay, so... Well, I'm going to Hammerhead anyway, so... Turn to car. Oh yeah, I've still got to turn in that bounty. Jeez. I'm so single-minded sometimes. Yeah, so I've got Carbuncle, and, next up, I'm going to be upgrading the Regalia. Or at least getting some different paint jobs in there. Because it's cool enough as is. Like, I love the design of the car. But I have the option to, make it look nicer. So, let's go to Hammerhead and turn in the bounty at Hammerhead, and then I'll stay at Hammerhead after I do that, and hopefully, after all is said and done, Cid will be done with the Ultima Blade, and then I can head to Altissia. Yeah, so he actually did show up in a photo earlier on the stream, but, like, the one where Noctis was, like, on the rock wall, but he might have been just a little bit off frame. Because he's like, hey, is that? Because that's the phrase that he uses whenever Carbuncle's on screen, I think.
Supply of curatives. Gotcha.
Yeah, because he'll usually say, like, oh, it's Gentiana if it's Gentiana. I'd say Carbuncle's probably my favorite creature in this game, though.
Nice work, Ed.
Because Carbuncle, like, made me love Fennec Foxes. Because I've actually got to hold a Fennec Fox before. Like, my own little Carbuncle. But surprisingly enough, Fennec Foxes are not as soft as they look. Because they have really rough fur because their climate is the desert. Yeah, they're noisy and they're very rough fur. It felt like a very thick rug, essentially, was what their fur felt like. I don't like to use that comparison, but that's the closest one I can think of. Wanted to ask earlier, but this is the Royal Edition? Yes, this is the Royal Edition on PC.
What can I do you for?
Let's customize the Regalia.
What are y'all after today?
What coat do you fancy?
I don't really have that much to upgrade. White paint, I guess that's kind of on brand for...
Anything in mind for the interior?
You know what? Just because cranberry, I'm going to use this one because of cranberry. Cranberries and cream.
How do you want the wheels?
I was thinking about buying this again, but if PC has mods, then I'd rather have that. Yeah, so a lot of it is like texture mods and stuff and like outfits, but there's also weapon mods as well. So like you can get the keyblade and stuff like that. Let's go with emerald. Yeah, emerald, just because that kind of matches my eyes a little
bit.
Well,
here's what I can do for her.
The Cindy Mobile.
How about the decals?
That's a little narcissistic, don't you think, Cindy? What have you done to our car? Then there's
anything
the gold
like?
Chocobo.
How about the decals?
Platinum Leviathan.
Like? How about the
16-bit buddies? Terra Battle.
Like?
I think I'm gonna go with the gold Chocobo.
Anything you like? How about the decals? Anything you like? How about the decals?
No, I don't like that. Because it just takes away the golden chocobo.
Anything you like? How about the decals?
Yeah, don't really have much in the manner of...
What are you fixing to upgrade? How's this? Y'all leave the hard work to me.
Yeah, there's not really much in that I have in terms of upgrades.
She's
for the Regalia.
For you. Have a look.
But we've got the Golden Chocobo. I mean, that's all that matters. We got the Golden Chocobo with the cranberry interior. I need to... Did I turn in that thing already? My short-term memory is terrible. Yeah, I did. Wait for Sid to finish the modification. Okay, Sid, well, I'm gonna stay the night at this caravan then. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. It's gonna go stay the night at the caravan. Because it's like 15 gil.
In King's Night? Oh yeah, I'm game.
In that case, I'll join you.
I love the detail that they're actually on their phones right now playing King's Knight.
I swear, half your photos are selfies.
Hashtag sorry not sorry.
Sid, finish the damn sword! Or do I have to sleep
it's
again? Yeah, we're just gonna play King. Where's Ignis? Oh, he's in there. Okay, so it looks like it's probably gonna force me to do a hunt, so.
Yo.
Hi.
But.
Oh,
too easy.
Anywho, I appreciate your help. Here's a little care package. Should make for good eating.
I'll just do a small hunt that's in this area. Oh. So if that's a thing, then let me go stay the night again.
Did he give you some food?
He said it makes good eating.
All right. I'll cook it up down there.
Yeah, I guess this caravan's gonna be our home for the next 3 days. Damn it, Sid!
Morning.
Back at ya.
Okay, let's try this again.
Sid's friends, was it?
Well, he's not going to be after just go fight one of these things.
You boys are a brave bunch. Make sure y'all go prepared.
Because, by golly, I'm gonna get that Ultima Blade before the end of the stream if it kills me. Brave bunch with rockets, machine guns, a golden car. I mean, we've got the works. I was hoping to just get a little information about Bionic Commando, but man, the walkthroughs I'm finding are terrible. I really just want a quick idea of what the objective is for the first level, and the walkthroughs keep telling me to download an emulator and play that way, or insulting, saying the level's really easy and you shouldn't need any help. I've tried 4 walkthroughs. Yeah, see, if I had any experience in the game, I'd try to help, but, like, I only know of the series. I've never actually played Bionic Commando. And, of course, Spencer through Marvel vs. Capcom. But yeah, like, that's the thing that I had trouble with the Skies of Arcadia walkthroughs, is that people wrote them in such a terrible format that it was hard for me to actually read any of them. Because they were from, like, 2006. That, and it's kind of the same thing with, like, Dark Souls. Like, if you want to look up a walkthrough for Dark Souls, you just have so many people who are just really condescending about it. Yeah, yeah, like, it's,
Everybody out.
Should be a nice change of pace.
Yeah, because not everybody, like, is gonna be... Knocked. Have overhead. Knowledge or... of emulation and a bunch of other stuff, so they can't just go in assuming that. Like, it's kind of that assumption, like, that somebody can just go out and buy, like, a new graphics card or, like, a console whenever something comes out. Like, oh, well, why don't you just upgrade? It's like, do you realize that stuff is, like... I don't know. It's just... It's frustrating.
The Prince of Pain.
Pronto! You rang?
Put it in the books. It's history now.
Dark Souls walkthrough, get good, that's one I saw. Yeah, that's kind of where the get good, like, whole shtick came from, was from Dark Souls, and also just, because, like, originally, like, whenever somebody would say GG, like, I always assumed that was a compliment. It's like, hey, good game. Like, I would actually, like, spell it out as good game, but nowadays, like, you can't tell if somebody's being, like, legitimately nice about having a good game, or if they're just saying GG, like, as an insult. All right. Ignis, now is not the time.
I can taste test for you.
Okay, what are they dropping? Just 3.
I'm going all out. Just
don't sure want to talk.
At least I was able to find a PDF scan of the manual. Like, enemies drop items, pick them up, but I don't know if those items actually do. Yeah, and that's another thing with, like, walkthroughs and games like that. Is if you're trying to encourage somebody to play the games, like maybe somebody who's never experienced it before, like insulting somebody's intelligence and just like making the walkthrough just like a huge turnoff, just like it just pushes people away and less people play a beloved game. I also realized that the Regalia is over there. Turn the car. There we go. Loading screen is still faster than driving there. Because wouldn't that be awesome? Like, whenever we need to go somewhere that's really far away, we could just use a loading screen to get in between from there to here, or from here to there.
Wanna come shopping with me, big guy?
Yeah, sure. Oh, it's just y'all.
Yeah, it's just y'all. And I'd like to get my Ultima Blade from Cid, considering I've waited 4 days for it.
I can tell you all about the area.
Oh, it looks like my stream cut out for just a second. Also not a fan of games that make me shift through 40 pages before it actually starts the guide. Like, they have spoilers for in the freaking intro revealing every single character in the game.
Make sure you're eating right.
Yeah, or they just kind of, like, explain, like, irrelevant information or just outright spoil the story of the game.
It's bedtime.
See, that's, like, whenever, like, I have to unsubscribe to a lot of, like, gaming news channels whenever, like, a game that I want to play comes out, because they have a really bad habit of putting spoilers in the thumbnails.
This should be a hit.
There we go, Sid.
Yeah.
Weapons ready. Swing by when you can.
Thank you, Sid, for finally getting my Ultima Blade done. Which means that I can go to Altissia shortly afterwards. I'm excited. And I've got plenty of time to spare. 20-ish minutes.
Everything in order?
Yep.
All right.
I have that on YouTube. A channel I don't subscribe to showed up as a recommended video with a huge spoiler right in the thumbnail. Yeah, it's like, what are people gaining from that? Like, just putting spoilers in the thumbnails. Like, I know it's just it's the same shtick whenever, like, a Marvel movie or some popular film comes out. Like, I had,
Ignis, pull over a sec.
I had not Infinity War, but Endgame spoiled for me because I was live streaming on my old YouTube project, and somebody decided that they were going to put a massive spoiler in my chat room. You can tighten that robe all you want, but we can tell the ribbon around the middle is working overtime, and let me tell you, if I were to peer from the front of the fabric with a microscope, we'd be able to see those fibers tear one by one. That's why you gotta put a limiter on how long you stream. You always gotta go back to your tailor before the time runs out. Good God. Sure, Dio. That's exactly the reasoning. Not because I have to go to work or anything. It's good to see you, Dio. So, we are about to actually leave Lucis. There's a couple, like, side quests and stuff that are here, but, like, they're just really irrelevant ones in the grand scheme of things. I've really completed all the stuff I want to do. So, I'm going to head to Altissia. After I get my improved engine blade. I'd like to stream longer, but work gave me a really weird schedule today. Like, I go in at 4:30 and leave at 8:30. Now that you have a mod here, you want the mod to ban. I already blocked them from the Twitch page, so they won't be able to do anything else.
Here she is, your weapon.
Great, appreciate it.
Gotta say, that's a right old, must have been 30-odd years ago when they was in service, over in Crown City. Finding the right tools for these relics took it out of me.
Sorry to hear.
Ah, but while I was rummaging through my stuff, an interesting item turned up. Go on, take it.
What is it?
A little something I'd loaned to your old man during our trip way back when. Reggie loved it so much he'd find every chance he could to help me out with it. But when it came time for him to give it back, he scratched some nonsense into it.
Nonsense?
Always irked me, so it's fitting I dump it on the sun.
So, like, you got a hammer?
And a story to go with it. Not a bad deal if you ask me.
An unexpected side of His Majesty.
Yeah. It is.
All right, boys. Let's go down the elevator. Oh, no. The game crashed! No! Why? You've got to be kidding me! Right... No! Why? What? That is such bullshit! No! It's okay, I should have an autosave. But at the same time, that makes me so mad. Oh, man. Okay, so I guess maybe I won't be able to get to Altissia. At least I'll be able to get to the dock to go to Altissia. But man, that's lame. Okay, good. It saved my progress. Altissia next stream! Woohoo! The manual is something I try to consider when helping people with old-school games, like to avoid spoilers. I feel the streamer is struggling with basic controls. It's usually okay to let them know stuff they are expected to have read in the manual. But of course, most people don't have the manual today, or they don't know how to read, like me. Let me see if I'll be able to do this. Because if it just pop... Okay, so I have to... go through that dialogue again. But what a time for the game to crash, am I right? Like, jeez. It's like, I got so excited that I was about to finally get to the City of Water. And then fate decided to throw a wrench into that gear system and... Damn it! But at the very least, I'm at the point where I need to be now, so.
Here she is. Great. Gotta say, that must have been fine on the right.
Sorry to hear.
Ah, but while I'm...
What is it?
A little something Reggie left, but when it came to...
Nonsense?
Always hurt.
So, like, you got a hammer.
And a story to go with it. Not a bad deal, if you ask me.
An unexpected side of His Majesty.
Yeah, it is.
All right, gentlemen, let's go down the elevator. Do I have to talk to Sid about it?
Oh, my aching back.
Oh. Umbra. Waiting for you in Altissia. Be there as fast as I can. That's probably the most optimistic. It seems like he's in a rush to get there, which we are. But like I said, I'll probably get to the dock area, but I probably won't be able to get onto the boat to Altissia just yet. Just because I've only got 10 minutes and there's like a full introductory phase.
Look, Prince Noctis, even the marshal came to say goodbye.
Oh, so you're telling me I can't save the game yet? Why? All right. Well, I guess we're gonna let it play.
What's that?
I'm sorry. Sorry I wasn't there for your father. I swore an oath to protect the king, but I wasn't strong enough to uphold it.
Ain't nothing nobody could have done to stop what happened.
Yeah. I realize that.
But you need to realize just what you mean to the boys by your side.
I do.
Even if they can't solve your problems, you can't hide what's going on from them. It hurts like hell. Remember, those ain't your bodyguards.
They're your brothers.
Trust in them, always.
Okay, can I save? No, it won't let me save! Okay, well, I'll just rely on the autosave for the time being. So, I actually have to dip out and get ready for work, so I'm just going to rely on the autosave from this point on, and then I'll just continue from this part whenever I start the next Final Fantasy XV stream. So, it was a short stream today, but it was a lot of fun. We're finally getting to the point that I really wanted to get to in Final Fantasy XV, because this is where everything kind of changes, because we're literally in another area of the world. Like, this is kind of where plot point, and it's just more and more plot. So, next stream, tomorrow will be tomorrow will be Resident Evil 6 and another game that I'm going to be playing. And tomorrow is my birthday, so this stream will probably be around 2 p.m. CST time. And then after that, there will be an after party that I will be having in VR chat for those who want to join that. It's not a requirement, just if you can stop by or just say hello, that'd be nice. But yeah, tomorrow at around 2 p.m. CST is when the birthday stream will start. I hope to see all of you there. But yeah, thank you all for joining me in my realm today, and I will see you next time.